So now let's try to test our dynamic link and let's try to uninstall the current application. So I'm going to uninstall the current application on the device here, and the application is now uninstalled. And now let's try to open this particular dynamic link and try to see whether this works or not. So this is the link which I have copied from Firebase, and here you can see like the link is now getting redirected. Play Store is now being opened on our device and it is asking us to install the application. So here you can clearly see like our application is not installed on the device, so it is redirecting us to Google Play to install the application. And now let's try to install this particular application and then again try to recall the URL again and try to see what happens next. So here you can see now our application is being installed here, and here now I'm trying to open the application. So our application is now successfully installed on our device, and let's try to open the URL again here. And now this time instead of opening the Play Store, it is opening our application. So this way we can create dynamic links which will open our application. If it is not installed on the device, then it will ask us to install the application from the Play Store and then it will open our application. In this vlog, we are going to deal with the app links that get redirected to your Play Store if you are using an Android application, and App Store if you are using iOS application. So here we are going to customize this particular link such that it gets redirected to these particular stores if your app is not installed on your device. So in our previous tutorials, we have seen the implementation of app links, which will be useful only when your application is installed. And this part of the tutorial will be helpful for you if your app is not installed on the user device. So I suggest you to watch this tutorial till the end. And if you are having any queries, and if you are starting with this particular tutorial, I suggest you to go through our previous tutorials which are displayed on the screen here. So this will be very much helpful for you to get started with the current tutorial. And if you are having a good knowledge on what is an app link and implementation of app links in Flutter application, so you can get started with this particular tutorial. So now let's get started with this particular tutorial and try to see how the app links that redirect you to the Play Store are implemented. So the very first thing here I'm going to show you is like the code which I have used in our previous tutorial. So I'm going to use the same code over here. So there is no change in the code here, and the link for this code I'm providing in the description section below. So don't try to code first, just try to understand the concept, then later you can easily code. So here let's try to see. So I'm not going to add any special dependencies for now here, and there needs to be some configuration to be done here. So let's try to see the build.gradle file here. I have added the Firebase here, so Firebase to our application. So previously we were dealing with app links manually, and now I'm going to deal this for redirecting our users to Play Store. So the first thing here, I have added the Google services under the dependencies here, and also let's go to the build.gradle like app level here, and here I have added the plugin as well, and also the Firebase dependency here. So I will be providing all these things in the description section below. So now let's get started with this tutorial. So here we also need to add the JSON file from the Firebase here. So this is a project which we have added here, and if you go back here, you can see this is these are the applications which I have added to this particular project. And if you want to remove any project here, you can just go to the particular settings and you can carefully remove this application instead of delete project. If you tap on delete project, entire project will be deleted, and all the projects, all the applications present in that particular project will also get deleted. So just make sure if you want to delete an application, just tap on remove this app instead of delete project. And also you can find the SDK instructions here, like how to add a project and how to download this particular JSON file and how to configure your application with the Firebase so that you can access the Firebase services on your application. So now I'm going to download this particular JSON services file here, and also you can find the same file here as well. So in the settings here, you can find like googleservices.json here, and make sure you add this particular file in the app directory here. So just close this app directory and open, and here you can find the googleservices.json file here. And this is a mandatory step you need to perform. If you have not added the JSON file, your project, your application won't be get detected by the firewall. And not only dynamic links, you cannot send push notifications or in-app messages. You cannot use any services from Firebase because your application won't get detected without this particular file. Let's try to see the Firebase console first. Firebase dynamic links, and you can clearly see like after August 25, 2025, you are not able to use dynamic links. As we already know, like dynamic links going to be not supported after August 25, 2025. But I'm getting requests regarding the dynamic link implementation. And also few of them are asking like redirect to Play Store or App Store. So the best way available currently is like Firebase dynamic links. And also I will try to find the alternatives in this particular regard. So for now, I'm trying to implement the redirection with the help of Firebase dynamic links. And you'll be having like 2 years of time. So I think in this particular 2 years of time, we will get with an another alternative, and you can switch to that particular alternative. So for time being, we can use the Firebase dynamic links. So now let's try to create the dynamic links. And here is the playlist for the Flutter Firebase dynamic links, which we have dealt previously. So if you are not aware of the Flutter Firebase dynamic links, so you can just go through these particular tutorials and get started again and can continue with this particular tutorial. So now I have already created a dynamic link here. And so here I have already created a dynamic link, and which I am going to explain you how to create this particular dynamic link now. So let's try to see the things again. So here, set up your short URL link. So this is the URL link which I have specified, and here I have specified Amplify app over here. You can just try to rename it. And here, set up your dynamic link. Here I have specified my website here. So the same website which I have specified in my code here. So if you go through the code here in the Android manifest file, I have specified amplifyabhi.com such that the links coming from this particular website will be detected and will be opened my application directly. And here dynamic link name. So you can just specify a name over here so that whenever you declare multiple links, you can just identify them with the help of the name which you have specified. And here define link behavior for Apple. So how it should work when you open this particular URL on an iOS device. And here open the deep link URL in a browser or open the deep link in your Apple app. So this is again based on your requirement. If the application is not installed on the user device, then it will be opened in the browser and get redirected to the App Store in case of iOS application. And the next thing is like Android. So here I have specified like open the deep link in your Android application, and I have also specified the Android application here. Like Flutter-Android is my project, and I have added my project already to the Firebase here. So these are all the list of my projects here available. And I have added like a Flutter-Android to the push notification project which I have previously created. And I hope you know how to create a project in Firebase. If not, you can just refer to our previous tutorials. Here I am providing the link again in the description section below. There you can know how to create a project in Firebase and add multiple applications to that particular project. And here, if your app is not installed, send the user to Google Play page for your app, or you can just specify any custom URL. For example, if you are having your own website where you want to specify some more details to the user, then you can just redirect the user to your website and from there to App Store or Play Store. You can also specify like open Play Store for versions slower than. And also you have like advanced setting like open Play Store for versions slower than. So if you think like you don't want to open your application and your application won't support a specific version and below versions of an Android application, then you can just specify the version over here such that all the links that get opened on that particular device will be going to browser instead of your application. So there are a lot of customizations when you try to make use of Firebase for your app links here. And let's try to see the next thing, that is campaign tracking. So you wanted to identify how many people have opened your app link, then you can make use of this particular campaign tracking here. And it's again optional here, you need not specify any settings for this. So if you are working on a real-time application, then this will be very much beneficial for you to identify how many people have opened your app link. And now we can save this particular link for now and try to make use of it in our application. So now let's try to test our dynamic link and let's try to uninstall the current application. So I'm going to uninstall the current application on the device here, and the application is now uninstalled. And now let's try to open this particular dynamic link and try to see whether this works or not. So this is the link which I have copied from Firebase, and here you can see like the link is now getting redirected. Play Store is now being opened on our device and it is asking us to install the application. So here you can clearly see like our application is not installed on the device, so it is redirecting us to Google Play to install the application. And now let's try to install this particular application and then again try to recall the URL again and try to see what happens next. So here you can see now our application is being installed here, and here now I'm trying to open the application. So our application is now successfully installed on our device, and let's try to open the URL again here. And now this time instead of opening the Play Store, it is opening our application. So this way we can create dynamic links which will open our application. If it is not installed on the device, then it will ask us to install the application from the Play Store and then it will open our application. So I hope this clears your queries regarding redirection URL in case of application not installed on your device. So this is it for this particular tutorial, and I'm going to provide the complete code in the description section below, and also we'll try to see the alternatives of this particular process as Firebase is getting deprecated regarding this particular dynamic links. If you are having any queries in this particular tutorial, do let me know in the comment section below. So if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.